When we face any numericals, any problems of hypothesis testing, we face first step. In first step here, when sigma or sigma scale, sigma is a standard deviation and sigma scale is the variance. When sigma or sigma scale is given in the numerical in the problem, then we always use z is equal to x bar minus mu over sigma over square root. Must remember. And x bar is the sample mean and mu is the population mean and sigma is the standard deviation and is the sample size. Must remember. First part is very, very easy. Second part is difficult, is very, very interesting when sigma or sigma scale is not given. When there is any numerical, any problem, sigma scale is not mentioned, is not given, then must remember, then you first of all check sample size. Must remember. If sample size, just focus on our sample size, must remember. If sample size is greater than 30, then we always use the test z is equal to x bar minus mu over s over square root of n. And must remember, s is the standard deviation, also standard deviation, but s is the biased, must remember. S is the simply used formula, square root of summation x minus x bar will be square root. But if you calculate the formula summation x minus x bar completely square, so must remember it is also equal to summation x square minus summation capital summation x square over small n. Must remember. You don't need to make a table to calculate that. Just use this formula to calculate the value of summation x minus x bar.